what I did was I was doing some cleaning the other day, and I come across this box, and I looked into it, and I knew what was in it. I've seen it sitting around for quite a while, but I got to looking a little closer at the items that are in it, and there are a bunch of furniture for a Barbie doll size doll, not a Barbie doll per se, but a Barbie doll size doll. And I've got a 3-year-old granddaughter, and I thought this would be neat to give her for Christmas, make a good Christmas gift for her. So I got to looking at them, and I noticed that some of them are in pretty bad shape. I believe my father made these some 15, 16 years ago, something like that. And these are in pretty bad shape. There's a chest of drawers, a bed. We've got the mattress for the bed, and a bed sheet. This is all made out of plastic canvas. And there's a chest that goes at the end of the bed. We got a little seat. We got another little chest here, full-size mirror, a rug. Let's see, we got a bedside chest or stand. There's even a bed tray, so you can eat breakfast in bed. And there's a few other things in here, like a that looks like a pillow maybe. That I'm not sure what it is. Looks like another pillow, and I'm not sure what that is. So I thought, I've got all this free time since I'm not going to be, don't look like I'm going to be working for a while, so why don't I just recreate this stuff for her Christmas? This is January. I could try and have it all done by December. And I thought, why not just videotape it and share it with everybody else, if anybody else is interested. So, this is what I'm going to attempt. I'm going to change a few things. I'm going to make it look more like wood than the white. I'm going to make it brown instead of white. There'll be some white here and there. So, I'm going to attempt to try this and see how it comes out. And I'm not an expert on plastic canvas, but I'm just using the designs that I see here. So I'm going to give it a try, and we'll see how things go. All right. What I'm going to do to start out with, actually I already started because I started working on the bed yesterday, last couple days, and I got as far as this. Got the main bed part, and let me show you how this is done. If you can see, I'm not sure if you can see, but inside this there are a bunch of little white or little plastic canvases sticking straight up to make it firm to lay on for the bed or the doll to lay on. You can see, might be able to see it inside there. So, and they're spaced out. I'm not really sure exactly how it was. I think I used each piece to try and space it out some. And then I patterned this here off of the bed itself. And instead of the white, I used the brown. And I haven't got the trim done on it yet. I'm going to wait till I get the ends before I do the trim. But it's coming along so far. Now, as far as the ends of it, I've started a pattern. And I think this is as close as I'm going to get to the bed, foot of the bed. I'm not going to put the heart in there because I really don't want it, not in the wood type, but I've tried to come as close to that as I can. So we'll see how it turns out. And I've noticed on this one here that this here has been doubled. And there's a different stitch on the front and the back. So I'm going to try and recreate this stitch as best I can. Like I said, I'm no expert. And I've noticed that there's a single piece right here that's been put in. I'm assuming that's for stability, because it does make it a lot stiffer. And what I'm going to do when I get to the top here, or the front, or the head of the bed, you see how this has come out like this. What I'm going to do is I'm going to go ahead and run this all the way down, because you see how that's leaning down like that. If I bring this all the way down, I'm hoping it will give this a little more stability too. There I've got pattern for the side of the bed, the foot of the bed, and I got the measurements for the flat of the bed, which is the bed spring part. That's what would be the bed spring, the flat of the bed spring. Okay, so I already got the straight edges here, so I'm just going to use those to start out with. So I'm going to go 48 this way, 43 this way, and 38 down. So I'll start at the top and count. 38. So right there's my mark. I have to cut two rows off, two and a half. Okay. Well, these two should match up. Perfect. Perfect match.